Hi, welcome everybody. This is an educational program. I'm Dr. Sameh Emil, a professor of cardiology, Military Medical Academy. And I wish to talk today about the diagnosis and how to treat acute coronary syndromes. We all know that acute coronary syndromes starts with chest pain, which is the salient symptom of these syndromes. Chest pain has some characters. It's retrosternal, it's compressing, it's related to effort, and it's relieved by rest or sublingual nitrates. So we have to have this criteria of chest pain to diagnose an acute coronary syndrome. Then the acute coronary syndrome itself usually comes with a prolonged chest pain. Sometimes it's not relieved by the sublingual nitrates, so the patient have to go to an emergency room to seek medical advice. And it's the first to do there is to do an ECG within 10 minutes of presentation, then to risk stratify our patient if he has any cardiac risk factors like hypertension, like diabetes, like smoking. And all these risk factors should be put in mind when we manage patient with acute coronary syndrome. Then we have to have an echo to diagnose the wall motion abnormalities for the patient with acute coronary syndrome, and to have some biomarkers, because we have to differentiate between an ST segment elevation myocardial infarction, that we have chest pain, ECG changes, and elevated biomarkers, and the non-STEMI, which we will have elevated biomarkers with ST segment depression in the ECG, or we have an unstable angina that we have chest pain and elevated biomarkers alone. Then the patient is, after risk stratification, is admitted to the CCU to have the medical treatment at first. If he is a STEMI patient, he will go directly for a primary PCI. If he is not a STEMI patient, he's an unstemi or unstable angina, he has admitted to the CCU to have the optimal medical treatment. Then, according to his risk stratification, he is scheduled either to continue on medical treatment or to have a coronary angio within a limited time. It's 24 hours or 72 hours or before discharge, according to his risk stratification. And according to the results of the coronary angio, the patient is managed either by doing stenting or by doing receiving a medical treatment or to go for CABG. So it's very important to diagnose first the acute coronary syndrome and to risk stratify our patient and to give them the better medical or interventional or surgical treatment. I hope that we all work together to improve the diagnosis and the awareness of this acute coronary syndrome. It's very important to do this to save many lives. Thank you very much for your attention.